Within California, the most recent volcanic activity occurred on the state's most popular winter sports slope, specifically underneath a peak known as Mammoth Mountain. There, in 1989, this peak was the site of a confirmed intrusion of magma underneath its edifice, but this thankfully stalled and is today still solidifying at 9.3 miles depth. However, this failed intrusion did generate another effect, as the solidifying magma has ever since released between 150 and 300 tons of carbon dioxide each day. This has seeped into several faults and fumaroles surrounding the mountain, resulting in large areas of dead and dying trees and vegetation, which can even reach lethal concentrations in some low-lying areas. This, sadly, even resulted in fatalities in 2006, which is why you need to follow these guidelines shown on screen when on or around the volcano. And, despite how eroded sections of Mammoth Mountain and its surroundings might appear, both of these regions have produced recent eruptions that could generate fatalities or damage if they were to occur again in the future. Specifically, Mammoth Mountain itself was last the site of two phreatic eruptions in the year 1252 CE, which occurred on its north flank, while its surroundings last produced a mildly explosive eruption which formed the two red cones south of the main edifice in the year 6500 BCE. This volcano is thus still active, having produced a volcanic eruption 64 times during its 233,000-year-long lifespan, translating to an average eruption of once every 3,641 years. 26 of these eruptions built the 4-cubic-kilometer lava dome complex known as Mammoth Mountain, while 38 of these occurred at various flank vents which each only erupted once, and placing around 8 cubic kilometers of lava and ash in the same time span. Each of these eruptions had a degree of explosiveness to them, meaning ash emissions that could disrupt regional air traffic and electrical systems, the chance for pyroclastic flows to occur from collapsing lava domes in more viscous or more explosive eruptions, and the threat of long-traveling lava flows which have flowed as much as 13 miles or 20.9 kilometers away from an erupting vent at this complex. It is for this reason, combined with the 7,200 people that live nearby in the town of Mammoth Lakes, that Mammoth Mountain is classified as a moderate threat volcano. The reason why the Mammoth Mountain volcano exists relates to the following. In California, the western portion of the state, which is a portion of the Pacific Plate, is sliding to the northwest, while the rest of the state is sliding to the southeast, which is a portion of the North American Plate. While 75% of this motion is accommodated by movement of the San Andreas Fault, a series of faults in eastern California known as the Walker Lane accommodates most of the other 25%. These Walker Lane faults serve as a path of least resistance for magma to intrude into, allowing for the creation of several closely spaced geologically recent volcanoes. As for why Mammoth Mountain is considered a separate volcano to the nearby Long Valley Caldera and Mono Inyo volcano relates to having a less alkali-rich composition, which is fairly distinct from the other two, indicating a different magmatic source for each of these three volcanoes. The first eruption from this complex occurred 233,000 years ago, emplacing a basaltic cinder cone which is now completely buried by the modern Mammoth Mountain. In fact, between 233,000 and 186,000 years ago, 18 such lava flows would be emplaced in the same general area via separate vents. The oldest lava flow beyond this area still remaining from this complex is associated with a basaltic tracheandesite cinder cone from 175,000 years ago. Additional cinder cones erupted intermittently during the following 85,000 years, with compositions ranging from basalt to dacite, and with two cinder cones producing the complex's largest lava flows 92,000 and 90,000 years ago. As for Mammoth Mountain proper, it formed through 28 primarily tracheodacite but also some rhyolitic eruptions, which would overlap one another to form a steep-sided series of lava domes between 100,000 and 50,000 years ago. These lavas did not travel very far from their source, and each were up to 400 feet thick. The construction of Mammoth Mountain occurred alongside the eruption of 14 peripheral vents representing the peak eruptivity in the overall volcanic field. Activity declined thereafter, with only 7 eruptions occurring since 50,000 years ago at the locations shown on screen. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.